very big dog called a Belgian Malinois. That's like a shepherd, only it's a golden color with a little black snout. And he is a guard dog. He doesn't like other people. He attacks and growls at him. And says, poor little coyote jumped up on my fence and jumped in the backyard. So my dog is named Zeus. That's a warrior of God. Racing towards this poor coyote, grabbed him. The two of them were snarling and snarling and biting, and the poor coyote was going to die.
Smile and say, oh, good, this is the problem I've
There's something in everything you go through in life that's going to help you. Now, I don't know what any of you want to gain out of your life, but I would pretty much bet that you all want to be happy. And I pretty much bet that you all say, I wish somebody would love me. And I wish that I were capable of loving someone. Because that's what brings the people. That's what makes you fun to get up in the morning. And when you have people around you who care, that is really important. So you can get busy, though, learning how to draw. Okay.
Get busy, but what you really want is you want to love somebody, you want to be loved. What if that somehow in your head you think, I'm no good, I don't account for anything, I'm really kind of stupid, and when I look in the mirror, I don't like what I see. In the book, Adventure is Reddit, I look in the mirror a lot. I look in the mirror and I say to the person in the mirror, do we have to go through this like I'm talking to myself? And we don't do that, right? We're in the mirror. So I talk to him, and he is always a counselor. It's like your id or your subconscious or something. It's always a counselor. Someone that's going to tell you that maybe you can do better. So it's always that. And so it's that thing that you find in your life, which is you don't think you're good enough. That is a lie. You are good enough, and you do have the ability to do wonderful, wonderful things. You have a talent. It's just something that it is. So if you have that, a whole different perspective of life happens. It's different. And I was lucky enough somehow in my life to suddenly realize that I was worthwhile. I grew up with a horrible inferiority complex. Strong. I don't have that anymore. Awesome. When I graduated from high school, I hadn't even read one book. That's called illiterate. Did anyone join me there? No. Has anyone not read one book and only one person?
I'll be great.
Come on. Anyway, literature will illuminate your life. It will make you knowledgeable. And if you don't know the words, look them up. But literature will actually illuminate your life. And if you can get this thing up here to be illuminated so that you really know who you are and what you want to do and what your dream is, hey, the rest of it is a piece of cake. So you have to get to that point. All right, so I've battled on for a while. So if you have any questions, let me give this floor to you. Go ahead and ask questions, and then you will take things and reflect. Yes.
Loud. So, do you think that there's still any interest in a traditional animation movie these days?
Do you think there's an interest still in 2D animation?
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you a question. How many in this room think that they would like to see another 2D animation? That's the problem. The people are the artists. The ones who don't believe it are those guys in the suits. Yeah. They'll go towards anything that's going to make money. Those are the cynics. Yeah, so somewhere, here's how it's going to work. Somewhere, someone is going to be good enough, and it's going to be someone in this room, to make an animated either short or whatever. It's going to make a lot of money, but it does. Those hairy ears of those men in the suit, they're going to go up and they're going to say, oh, money, let's go there. So that's how it happens. Money needs to drive everything. But animation, let me go back to Walt. Walt actually, he was a dreamer, he was a storyteller, and he loved the art. And he knew very well that the art was the important thing. And he had said this one time to the men who came in and wanted to sell the movie. And those men came in and said, this is what we need to sell. And he said to them, I'll make the picture, and it's paid, you can sell. That doesn't happen so much today. No. We'll tell you what we can sell. Make the picture do that. That's called pandering. So, that's not a good thing. Anyway, any other questions? Let's go there. Yes, sir.
So, a big part of your legacy has been keeping all of the information up in the life. So, is there anything with the changing face of animation right now? if they're old enough to be thinking, they never should be able to back for
very good. I've never heard this question. What would make animation funded to come back so people would like it? Let me tell you that the magic of animation is actually the story. Frank Thomas, you may know who has this, but it's hard. Frank Thomas said, you can animate the most beautiful animation in the world. I think that's fabulous. I know everything about how to move, how to anticipate, you know all of that. Watch and stretch. If the story's not good, it comes to zero. Turn it around. If you have the most wonderful story in the world, it's really, really good, and you've got sloppy, horrible, terrible animation, the story will still flow. I don't entirely agree with that, but you have to be somewhat so it's believable. But you want to suspend the disbelief. You want the audience to think that no one drew that. Surely when I'm watching a very old picture like Bambi, and I see Bambi, that moment on the meadow, that moment on the meadow where his mother says, Bambi, quick, think. He starts running, yes, faster, faster, she screams. The music is now telling me what's going to happen. And finally you hear, Bambi rocks, we made it, mother, we made it, we made it. That's not drawing. If I'm a little boy, and I was when I saw it, I watched my mother being shot. And there she sits beside me. But then I'm feeling something that's really, really strong right here in my heart. I'm feeling that. What did this be like when my mother not get shot, but she's gone? So that's what the animation did. And Walt knew this, and he did it using symbols. When the little rabbit said, mother says, what did your father tell you? Which time? You know, all that one. Now, this is not a rabbit, he's drawing. This is a symbol for a little boy that the audience already knows because they live with one. Oh, if you can't say something nice, don't say nothing better at all. Don't say nothing at all. Okay, but how does that touch you? And then I go to a lot of the films I look at today, and I close my eyes and put my fingers in my ears and don't even watch this junk. So I look at them, and it gets through the heart. It turns into a bunch of what they call, what they call just badass jokes. One joke after another, so when I walk out of the theater, there's nothing to take home. I didn't feel anything when I watched it. It's just 3D and moving and it looks good and I didn't have anything else to do. So I watched it. That's not it. Unless you can communicate to your fellow beings with a heart, with something you feel, then you don't deserve to be an artist. You should go to do something else. That's what I said. Any other questions? Yes, over here in the orange.
I'm 200 pounds. Go as fast as I can.
A very fast movement.
First, I want to take the opportunity to tell you that you are a treasure to everyone in this room, but especially me. I'm a storyteller, a net voice with an artist, and we live through your art and through your storytelling. The commitment to truth that you just talked about is what makes the magic of watching anything you create.